Hey everyone, welcome to a new episode of Tech Guru, the channel where I give superpowers to products using the magic of tech. Normally, I like to upgrade products you can buy in stores, but today we're going to do something a little bit different. In the previous episode, I built a custom Lite Brite where every peg was able to light up on its own. This opened up a whole new world of possibilities. We were able to do animations, a small visualizer, I even got it to play a mean game of Tetris. After I hit the publish button, I realized something was missing. And no, I'm not talking about the amount of subscribers on this channel. The Lite Brite itself was missing a second upgrade. The first upgrade was done. The lone light bulb was replaced with a marquee's worth of lights. The second upgrade is these flimsy sheets that come with the Lite Brite. These things are meant to be reusable, but they're more like a one-hit wonder. Of course, you can buy more in the store, but you're limited by the selection. You can always go online and download more, but then you need to remortgage your house just to be able to afford all the black ink that you'll have to use. What other options are there? Use your imagination? If we relied on imagination to create the art, this video would be rendered useless, so let's just keep going. This got me wondering, what if I made a Lite Brite that could generate the art for you instead of relying on these flimsy sheets? This is exactly the project that we're going to tackle today. To speed things up, as a starting point, we're going to use the Lite Brite from the previous video. That Lite Brite is now called Tech Brite. To create the art, we're going to rely on AI. AI can be used for a lot of things, like making videos of animals eating spaghetti or taking over the world. No, not animals eating spaghetti taking over the world. Though I guess that is possible too. For this project, we're gonna do something even crazier. We're gonna see if it's possible for AI to generate Lite Brite sheets for us. Since my Lite Brite can't surf the internet on its own, at least not yet, we'll skip the browsing part and use an API instead. So now you might be wondering, what's an API? Think of it as a way for two apps to communicate to each other instead of meeting up in person. The Lite Brite will send a request to the ChatGPT API and it's gonna respond with an image. There are a few issues with using ChatGPT though. First of all, the smallest image it can generate is 1024 by 1024. That's 32 times bigger than our Lite Brite screen. Now you may be thinking, why not just shrink the images down? And yeah, we could do that, but you lose a lot of quality. This is about as satisfying as microwaving fries. For these images to really pop, they'll need to be a lot simpler with fewer details. If you've ever used a Lite Brite, you know that not every hole gets a peg. If we did that, it would take forever to fill in a sheet. The Lite Brite uses its black background to its advantage. It focuses on the edges of the artwork. This creates that neon glow effect that we all love. It makes it look like something straight out of the 80s. Luckily, ChatGPT allows us to give it custom instructions. I can ask it for limited colors, no backgrounds, and have a subject in the middle of the image. Sometimes it even listens to me. I can even ask it to make it Lite Brite style, but honestly, it struggles with that. So to recap, we're going to ask ChatGPT to generate an image for us, and then we're going to take that image and modify it so it's more compatible with the Lite Brite. All right, it's time to dive into our algorithm. Now, when you watch somebody make something on a YouTube video, you usually only see the cool stuff. You don't really see the failures. I've been guilty of that as well, but trust me, for every success, there's dozens of oh no's and oh, that shouldn't have caught on fire. With an algorithm though, I think it's worthwhile sharing the progress, even the moments where it looks like I handed a toddler my homework. That's why I've created a second script that will show you all the attempts that I've done. Think of it as a blooper reel, but instead of laughter, it's just me crying on the inside. Okay, so let's see what my script can actually do. These five images here were all created using ChatGPT. They all follow the exact same instruction set. I asked for a subject in the middle of the image. I asked for a simple background, reduced color sets, and sharp edges. The image here is of Krusty the Clown. This one I just got from the internet. I just wanted to see if it was able to process a real image as well. This was actually surprisingly decent. You can kind of see the resemblance of the original images, but you can't fully tell what everything is. You can maybe determine that this is a house. No idea what this is. This looks kind of like a sunny side up egg. This pizza looks like it's melting. I don't think anyone can figure out that this is a pig, and this kind of looks like a half bagel with cream cheese. I should also mention that I created a little filter to see what this would look like on an actual Lite Brite. I fixed the background images, but you still really can't tell what everything is. I'm going to need to work on the edge detection a little bit so that we don't have all of these little random dots everywhere. This should also help with Krusty the Clown. This is just edge detection. The rainbow looks less like a bagel now, but everything else didn't fully work out. You can also see that it added a border around some of the images here. The house maybe looks a little bit better, but nothing else really worked that great. So let's try something else. Let's try, what if we only do black and white? Maybe this purple is causing an issue. This would be great if I was making a 1970s video game, but it's actually not terrible. You can kind of see a little bit more detail. The house really looks like a house now. Krusty looks nothing like Krusty. The pizza still looks terrifying. And the pig, I don't know what's going on with that pig. Let's try adding a little bit of color now. Okay, this looks a little bit better. The house definitely looks nicer now. The rainbow is starting to look like a rainbow, and the rest look just terrible. What I did with this attempt is I reduced the amount of colors available, makes it look like a Windows operating system from the 1990s. The pizza is actually looking a little bit better, and you can kind of see a little bit of a smile here in the sun. Krusty looks a little bit more like Krusty than any of the other pictures. The rainbow is still kind of okay-ish. The house can use some work. Let's just put that light bright filter on to see. Yeah, this won't work. Now, what if we reduce the colors but match the color palette of the actual image? And that's what I did with attempt number 7 here. And this actually looks fantastic. The only problem with this is that these aren't light bright peg colors, so I can't actually use this. However, because I'm using an RGB matrix, I could, in theory, put white pegs everywhere and have the matrix generate the colors for me instead of the pegs, but that would be cheating. Now, this is basically the same thing as my attempt number 7. What I did here is I only included the colors from a light bright, and you can see that this is starting to shape up a little bit better. There's obviously a bunch of mistakes. Krusty is missing a lot of detail, but you can kind of see that we're getting there now. The rainbow definitely looks fantastic. I think I'm very impressed with how this one turned out. I'm not sure what happened here. This looks exactly the same as attempt number 8. Yeah, that looks identical. I probably spent a lot of hours working on this and came out with the exact same result. Attempt number 10. I decided to grayscale this image before doing anything, and then I added the color back in. Didn't really improve much. What I did here is I removed the backgrounds from the image, and I attempted to put purple when background was being removed from the subject. However, that didn't seem to work out very well. You can see a lot of holes in the images, so this was quite a failure, and I should probably go back to buying these light bright sheets. What I wanted to do is take the original image and simply reduce the color so that it matches the colors of the light bright. The color matching is pretty decent. I did have problems matching it before, but this turned out pretty well. Now with attempt number 13, I decided to apply the light bright filter on it. Krusty is looking a little bit better here. Maybe this kind of looks like a pizza. The sun is starting to look like a sun. For attempt number 14, we're basically in good enough territory. This is actually looking really good. What I did is I applied some bias, because if you look at 13, what was happening here is that black was getting chosen more than any other color, and so was white. So if a color was pretty close to white, or if it was a very bright color, it would choose white instead of that color. And so if we go back to 14, what I did here is I reduced the bias, so it would have to be very, very close to white in order to choose white. And you can see that this is actually working out pretty well. This is looking good. I think we're close here. For attempt number 15, I tried to match the colors a little bit better, but the results are mixed. You can see that Krusty became a little bit nicer, but then you have these little random problems here. Let's see what this would look like on a light bright. Actually, this is nice. This was a complete disaster, so we will ignore 16. Attempt number 17 is very similar to attempt number 15. I think this was good, and I think this is what I'm going to roll with. I like this. Let's put that filter on. Yeah, this looks good. I'm very happy with these results.
I know this script isn't going to work 100% of the time, but the important part is that it works most of the time. If it generates an image that I don't like, it's not a problem. I can just ask it to generate a new one. It's kind of like swiping on a dating app, but without the heartbreak. Now I have a new problem. I've generated the images, but how do I get them back on the light bright? While the Tech of Bright does have a computer inside of it, it's not very powerful. It's like asking a hamster to run a marathon. What I'm going to need to do is, talking to this microphone, it's going to send a request to ChatGPT. ChatGPT will return the image to my computer. My computer will handle all of the processing, and that's going to send the image back to the light bright. Hopefully all that's gonna work and nothing will get lost in translation. Now let's pause here for a second because it's time for another script. This one's a lot simpler, so I won't bore you with all the details. On a high level, I need to take my generated image and create a very simple file out of it. This file consists of two parts. One, a list of all the colors that we support, and two, their placement on the Lite Brite screen. This might remind you of the flag example from my NES album video. And just when you thought we were done, we now need another script. This one's gonna live on the Tech of Brite itself. This script will need to do three things. One, it needs to be able to understand the file that we just created. After that, it will need to find all the non-black colors and display them on the screen. And third, when I finish placing all my pegs on the screen, I want to be able to shake the Tech of Brite so that the colors all turn to white. Since all the pegs have their own color, I no longer need to show that color. I can switch to white, which is much brighter. This will make the image pop. Let's test this out.
This is a simple webpage that I built that will take whatever I say and send it over to ChatGPT. ChatGPT will take my prompt and generate an image for me. That image will then run through my script, which will generate a Lite Brite compatible image, which will then show up over here. Let's try this out. A dino eating pasta. How cool is that? A cat eating pasta. There we go. A flying car. A hamburger. This is pretty cool. My kids are gonna love this. Let's try something a little bit more difficult. A rocket leaving a planet in space. That is so cool. A cute dog.
There you have it. My Lite Brite cannot generate images on its own. Well, sometimes. Thank you for sticking around, and if you like this video, please hit the subscribe button. This is probably my last Lite Brite video, so stay tuned next time for brand new projects.